98online.com/livewire.
Oh no.
Is this it?
Is this it? God damn it. Here we go. Here we go. All right, if you're listening with a cassette deck,
son of a B.
Get ready to hit record. I went to his webpage already.
Why did you do that?
There's nothing there.
Oh.
I'm just saying. I think we're going to have to take it straight from the horse's soft, spittly mouth.
Nope. I am posting it right now.
Oh, you son of a... I'm not going to go. I'm going to wait. This is...
Okay. Oh, there's like a video attached to it or something.
Yeah, that's right. There's a video.
And now, Angela Greenberg, it's time for another episode.
I already screwed it up!
Take two!
He's so nervous.
And now, from the twisted mind of Spiegel, it's time for another episode of... Make Justin and Scott Cry! Here's Spiegel with today's story.
I got a good feeling about this one.
Shh!
Sorry. Grab some tissues. This story is about a family in Canada.
I already hate it.
You already hate it? Why?
Damn Canadians.
Yeah, I actually hate the Canadians as well.
I like to call them America's hat.
Okay, this is a story about a family in Canada. A man, his wife, and their two young sons. One of the boys is sick. He's 4 years old.
Oh, boy.
He has a heart condition. He needs treatment, but has to go to a hospital far from home. His mother left home with the little four-year-old. They traveled 300 miles to another Canadian city to get treatment. And during that time, they stay at the Ronald McDonald House. Listen to this.
I'm Angela Greenberg. I've been at Ronald McDonald House this time for the last 3.5 months with our son, Joel. He was born with a congenital heart condition. My husband, Mark, and my other son, Mathieu, they're at home in Saskatoon, then I'm here in Edmonton with Joel. It can be rough some days.
Well, Dad back home hundreds of miles where he's a transit worker, and between shifts, he takes care of his oldest son. The Canadian airline WestJet and the Ronald McDonald House teamed up to reunite this family. So get this, a WestJet employee learned how to be a transit worker. He trained to be a transit worker so he could fill in for the father. Whoa. While the dad went to see his wife and sick son.
Thanks to our partners at WestJet, we are about to embark on a remarkable journey, a chance to support one of our families, the Grimard family, in a way that we have never supported a family before.
My name is Medell, and I'm CSA at WestJet. That's a customer service agent. I'm here to make our guests travel a little bit easier. What I'm about to do is train as a city worker in the transit division. I'm gonna do Mark's job, and I'll be his replacement for 5 days so he can go to Edmonton and visit his son Joel and wife Angela. As a dad, I wanna help a fellow father out. It gets pretty messy and it gets pretty hot, but I hope I do good and not screw up. I don't think he's suspecting anything.
Oh, Dad doesn't know.
It's just business as usual for him.
Yeah, so now the plan was in place. The WestJet employee had to meet the dad and give him the good news.
Hey, Mark. My name is Medell. I'm actually a WestJetter. I actually been training to do your job so you can visit your son at Ronald McDonald House today. Here's your plane ticket, and yeah, get out of here. I got this.
So off the man went, flying 300 miles to reunite with his wife and 4-year-old son. Listen closely to the reunion in the hospital room, and the little 4-year-old comes in being held by his mother, and his father and his brother are sitting in the hospital room, and the little boy sees his father, and listen to how he starts to laugh with joy. And how did Dad feel after the reunion, seeing his little boy?
As a dad, to be able to be close to your sick child, especially when they're away from home, as a parent, there's nothing more important.
If you want to see video of the story and reunion, text Josh News.
Don't have the words to say how grateful I am.
Enough with the Josh News.
Just
we get
a
it.
A huge thank you and very much appreciate it.
Son of a bitch, you got me. Go ahead, live wire. Eat it up, camera one.
Josh News to 56332. When I watched the video this morning before the show, I was very near. Bawling.
You got me.
Oh, we tried to call my dad in the middle of it. I can't get a hold of him. Can we just at least talk to Ron or one of our dads?
Justin's doing the ugly cry.
Yeah, all my cries are ugly. God damn it, man. Listen. You pointed at the cheap seats.
I'm crying, okay?
You pointed at the cheap seats like,
God,
babe, effing
good.
Ruth.
That was like silver platter served up, though, with the music and everything, you son of a bitch.
Whoever put
that
together.
Was part of the video. I didn't.
Yeah, no, I know.
Mike, try him one more time.
The only thing.
He might be pooping.
But that's a good idea. Mike, future cry segments, music, please.
Oh, man. I like the fact
that Dad didn't know. They surprised him with that, and the guy's like, I got this, buddy, go. And he did it because he was the dad, and he wanted to help another dad. That was awesome. The dad going there saying, you know, with sick kid far away, that got me. The music got me. The only thing I didn't like.
I'm glad the kid lived.
If I'm being nitpicky, it was a little bit too much of a commercial for that airline.
Well, this is the same airline
that did the other thing with
the gifts. Yeah, for all.
They're
the
very good at those
things.
Oh,
God. WestJet?
Yeah.
You got it together. Looking at you, Delta.
It just was a little commercially for me.
God damn it.
But other than that, you got me, you son of a bitch.
I cried. You got me. You fully got me. Oh,
God,
you
it was good.
Rick.
Happy Father's Day.
Oh, happy Father's Day
well
to you.
Well done, Spiegel.
Well done. I tell you what. The only thing that would have made that any worse.
You know what it is when you think of a 4-year-old that's sick. I mean, they're innocent, you know, complete innocent creatures.
Man, it's not his fault.
It's nobody's. It's just horrible to think.
He's got a hole the size of an avocado in his heart. It's not his fault.
Damn it.
Oh man, Dad, I know you listen. You know the number. If you really want to hear the. Oh, here it comes again.
What are you trying to reach your dad for?
Because tell him I love him and I miss him and I'm sorry I don't get down enough to see him.
Well, at least you have a father. Both of you have fathers.
Don't laugh at me. I have the worst cry in the world.
You're losing it. Lock it down. Hey.
Let him go. It's okay.
Let it out.
Let it out. Let out that raw emotional release.
Hey. Hey, lock it down.
I'm locked down.
Look at you.
18, kid. B.A. Baracus. You ain't getting me on no plane.
Lock it down, would you? Jesus.
I got to talk to him a lot recently, but I never get to see him.
Whose fault is that? He's 67, fat and old. He ain't going nowhere.
That's why I wanted to.
You
got to
go.
He's got diabetes.
You
got
to go.
It's on me. He's going to lose a leg soon. Both of them. They're purple. God, you're good at your job, Josh. You are good at your job. StudyItOnline.com.